the output is going to be 115 volt, 200 volt DC, 3-phase, 400 hertz. So that voltage must be kept constant by the voltage regulator in the GCU. Okay, so this must be kept constant by the voltage regulator, and that 400 hertz also must be kept constant by the means of CST. So the whole operation of the generator will be controlled and monitored by the GCU. So what is GCU? Generator control unit. So every generator in the aircraft has its own GCU. So provide automatic control and protection function for each channel by monitoring the IDG output. It contains a voltage regulator and also for fault protection. And there is a voltage regulator and also another circuit for fault protection. Power required to operate internal GCU circuits and external DCB and VTB protectors is derived from the IDT permanent magnet generator. Okay. And then the backup power comes from the aircraft and the input DC. So actually the GCU is the control unit. It's a computer, right? It's a computer which will monitor everything on the generator, on its generator. So of course, when we talk about the computer, of course it has microprocessor, the memory, the input, and also projection outputs. So inputs come from the various area. It comes from the AMD, come from the output of the generator, it comes from the final operation. Okay, anywhere related to the generator, it will process, okay, and it will give an output appropriately. Okay, maybe to give an indication, so all the signal from to give indication to what comes from the system. Okay, and it also has the data bus to or from the DPCU. Okay, bus power control unit. So this is the BPCU. BPCU also a computer, right? Which controls the power on the bus. It also controls the power from external. Okay, external power monitoring and protection, load shedding and utility and on utility and daily bus. And this is where insufficient of power. Okay, non-essential load must be off. That is done by the BPCU. Side bus differential protection, control on external power contactor, and control on ground handling relay and ground circuitry. So each GCU and BPCU has built-in test equipment, because it is an electronic component, electronics unit. It also has a bright system and built-in test equipment, which have a self-check and fault diagnosis capability. So this unit, when we want to test either the component or the DPCU or the DCU is okay, we just put a test function. So it will test and diagnose its own circuit and it will give a result. Okay. So the bright display and control are mounted on the DPCU. This is one example of the DPCU. It's a black box with the display, with the test button and all the circuit inside. When you press the test button, it will diagnose its own circuit. If there is any fault in its in itself, it will give a report. So this is a BPCU. It's also a computer. It also consists of the microprocessor, memory, ports, and the outputs. Right? And it also has the data buses to or from the number of GCUs available in the aircraft. Okay, now we go to the circuit breaker. Okay, as we know, circuit breaker is to treat the circuit when we have a condition where, for example, overcurrent, okay, or a very high current in the circuit, maybe due to the short circuit, whatever. But the CV may control one line, one circuit, or it can control more than one circuit. Okay, so this type of CV normally applied as a GCB or PVB or APB. Right? GCU. Okay, BTV is a bus time tracker. So it also some kind of CB. Okay, and APB is a APU breaker. So it is a similar. And they use a similar concept. Right, these are identical circuit breaker. Main contact allows electrical power source to the bus. But if something happens to the generator, okay, something happens to the generator, there's a fault on the generator, GCU will acknowledge this. Okay, GCU will get a signal from this faulty generator. GCU will send the signal to trip the GCB. How to trip the that contactor connect the generator to the bus. Right, because this generator is faulty. Right. So normally that CB is a latch 5. Okay, latch 5. So we have the electromagnet and we have a component magnet, right? And this unit can receive two signals. Either the signal is to bring all the contactors to close, or the signal is to trip the circuits. Okay? So the signal is produced by the control unit, maybe from the ECU or BBCU. So when closed while energized, the circuit breaker closes, permanent magnet provides holding force to latch the circuit breaker in closed position. Alright. Okay, on this diagram, when there is a signal come from the GCU, for example, okay, that signal is the signal to close the circuit. Okay, it's a signal to close all the circuits. So when the signal comes in, okay, it will flow across this electromagnet. Okay, and the magnetism here will pull all the contactors to make all the circuit close. So this means that the system is operating and supplying the power. Okay, so from this position, we will change the position to down. When the fault sensed by the GCU, the fault is on the generator sent by the GCU. GCU will process this signal. It will send a signal to trip all the circuit. Right, so that signal will go into the CB. Okay, it will flow across this electromagnet and depolarize the magnetic field. So now the magnetic field now not able to hold all the contactors anymore. So the spring will bring all the contactors to open them back to this position. So I think we have a closed signal come back to from the GCU. So this is the type. This is the latch type of CB. Two zener diodes are there to suppress RP when breaker is opening or closing. Across the coil, normally they put a diode. And this is to prevent from the EMF and back EMF to produce a spark on the contactors. It's the same function. During the opening or closing of these two contactors, it prevents from the spark happens there. That's the function of this diode. And then fault protection. So as we know, GCU monitors and generator control unit monitors anything happens on the generator. So GCU monitors the main generating channel. In the event of system fault, it treats the GCR. What is GCR? Generator control relay. That GCR will be tripped when the fault has been found by the GCU on that generator. So when this GCR trip, it will stop the excitation current to the field winding, which then trips the DCB. Okay, after GCR trip, GCB will trip. Okay, GCB trips means disconnecting that faulty generator from the system. Right. Once tripped, there must be a reset procedure, which is to switch off the generator control switch and then switch it on again. So what is the fault that will be monitored by the GCU on the generator? These are the faults, right? Over voltage instead of 115 volts. If the voltage increases 130 volts, that means over voltage happens. This must be disconnected and this generator must be disconnected. That is done by the GCU. Under voltage instead of 115 volts, reach 100 volt, get considered under voltage. That generator also must be disconnected. Okay, and then what else? Under frequency, instead of 400 Hz, if the frequency drops at 365 Hz, that considered as under frequency. Right? This generator must be trimmed. Over frequency, 430 Hz, generator must be trimmed. Okay? So, the, whatever it is, GCR and GCB will be trimmed by the GCU. And then what else? The open phase, over current, shorted PMG, under speed, shorted rotating diode, and differential protection. All these will be monitored by the GCU. If the generator have any kind of this fault, that generator must be disconnected. GCR will be tripped, GCB will be tripped. Again, GCR trip means no excitation current in the generator. GCB trips means that generator will be disconnected from the bus. So what is differential protection? Line to line, and line to earth fault between generator and bus bar are detected by this circuit. It has any feeder fault. Compress the current going to and leaving the generator, right? For differential protection, in this three-phase system, normally they use a current transformer. So normally we use the emitter to measure the amount of current. But when you want to measure the amount of current in the circuit, the emitter must be put in series. In that, you need to remove the wire and measure between the wire. But in some system, such as in the power distribution system, this is a power cable. It's a bigger size of wire. Okay? Normally, this system comes together with its current transformer. Okay? One of the functions of the current transformer is to measure the amount of current without putting it in series with the line. Okay? So actually the current transformer is a toroidal shape of coil. Like a donut. It's a coil. Donut shape. Okay? And it has its output line. So it is one line and then one and goes out. Okay? And then this toroidal shape actually they put outside of the wire that you want to measure the current. This is the wire. Okay, the term transformer is what? Either to step up or step down. Power transformer means step up of voltage or step down of voltage. But here is the current transformer. It has the same concept, but the function is different, right? So as we know, in the transformer we have a primary winding and secondary winding. So normally this one is connected to the power source. This one is connected to the the wire is the primary winding, but it is not in the winding form, it is in the wire form. So there is a current flow inside. Okay? Concept of transformer, when we have a magnetic field change, we have a mutual induction. Here, okay, the magnetic field will cut the coil, it will produce the EMF. Same concept here, when there is a current flow in this single wire, it also produces a magnetic field around it. And only it also brings so magnetic field here will collapse and expand due to the AC. So the magnetic field will cut this toroidal coil, and what will be induced inside this toroidal coil is the EMF. Right? So what happened? Voltage is very high because the turn ratio. One wire and very so many number of trains. Voltage will be stepped up. But stepping up voltage means stepping down of current. So the current, there will be a current flow here. So whatever current, let's say we have 60 amps in this line. Due to the turn ratio between this wire and the toroidal shape, yes, voltage is stepping up, of course. But current maybe they read at 6 amps, for example. So that 6 amps is used for the ammeter to give a reading. So maybe on inside the ammeter there's also another mechanism, of course. So it will give a reading of 6 ampere is measured on that line. In that line. So this is a basic function of the current transformer, right? For the circuit protection, okay, normally they use a current transformer, right? The three output lines from the three-phase AC generator comes together with its current transformer. So every line has the toroidal shape of coil around it inside this unit, right? Okay. So, three CTs, CT is current transformer, one on each phase, okay? Phase A, phase B, phase C, so we have 1, 2, 3. They can be external to the generators or integrated in the generator, okay? The three CTs are located downstream of the generator bus, okay? This is a generator. That is CT. And then we have bus, and this is the line to the nodes. And here also has CTs, a current transformer. So now, this current transformer will measure the current flow in every line, and this current transformer will measure the current flow in this line. And those signals will be compared in the system. Okay, so what is the current that should be supplied to the loads must be the same amount of current that flow from the ground to the generator. Okay, if something happens, maybe two lines shorted, or maybe these three lines shorted, or maybe any of the lines shorted to the ground, we may have a change of any of the line. We may have a change of amount of current in any of the line, right? Current transformer output are fed to the differential protection circuit in the GCU. So actually the signal here and the signal there will be sent into the GCU. So it is actually inside the GCU. Okay, so the signal will be compared. Under no fault condition, generator's current transformer and load's current transformer has same EMF use, but opposite direction. Okay, like I said just now, when it measures the amount of current, this one also produces current in the circuit. Right? In this case, it will send to the GCU to compare the other ones. Right? So this one measure, the whole unit will give one value of current. This one measures, the whole unit will give value of current. Okay? So inside the GCU, if this one measures the same amount of current as that, this unit will produce the same amount of current to that. Okay? For example, here it measures and it produces 20 amps, and from there it also produces 20 amps. Okay? Those signal will be sent into the GCU, compared, they will also flow. Okay, this is a very simple example. We have a relay connector. So when 20 amps flow and 20 amps flow, nothing happens on the relay. Because those two currents come from opposite way with the same amount. Nothing happens on the relay because positive 20 amps, negative. Okay, 0 amp on the relay. So relay has no current, relay is not energized, nothing happens to this contactor. Okay. In this example, this contactor is used to bring the signal to trick the GCR and trigger GC. At this condition, actually, we have a very good condition. Okay, but when there is a fault, okay, example here, line, this line shorted to the ground. 4P, right? Induced EMF are not safe, right? So what happened? As we know, when some wire shorted to the ground, the current will flow in that line only. So the total of current measured by these three CT will be different with the total current measured on that line. Example, because this line has been shorted, this measure 30 amps, for example. Higher current because shorted to the ground. And that line or that CT measure normal, 50 amps. So what happens now? These two amount of current, one is higher, 30 amps, goes to the relay, 20 amps goes to the relay. Total is 30 minus 20. So we have 10 amps of current flow in the relay. So when there is a current flow in the relay will energize. Okay, energize means it controls that contactor, right? So the contactor close. Close means, okay, this positive power, maybe DC, DC signal is sent to the unit to trick the DCR and then trigger DC. Okay, DCR again is a conductor control relay. It's also a relay. If the same signal, the relay will trigger conductor. Then DCB also a CB is now. Okay, it also give a trip signal to trip the conductor to disconnect the generator from the line. So this DCB is open. Okay, how can this DCB open? Because it receives a signal to trip. When there's a fault. So this is another type, one type of circuit protection we have in the DC system. Okay, any questions? Anything to ask? Alright, so you don't have any questions, stop here. But the load shedding and load sharing will be explained in a separate video.